rather go to the lonesome valley. You.
Dred Scott was born as a slave in 1795 in Southampton County, Virginia. In 1832, Scott moved to Missouri with his master, Peter Blow, who later died in the year 1832 with his wife. In his will, Peter signed Scott over to Dr. John Emerson of the U.S. Army.
While under the ownership of Emerson, Scott lived in two free states, Illinois and the Wisconsin Territory, which were both free regions under the Missouri Compromise.
While in the Wisconsin Territory, Scott married Harriet Robinson in 1836.
Missouri requested for admission to the Union in 1819 as a slave state, threatening the balance between slave states and free states. Congress granted Missouri a request by admitting Maine as a free state and drew the 36-30 line across the former Louisiana Territory, creating a boundary between free and slave regions. The line excluded slavery for all new states in the Louisiana Purchase, north of the southern boundary of Missouri.
In 1840, Scott and his wife moved back to Missouri with Irene Emerson, and when John Emerson died in 1843, Irene was given ownership of Scott and his family. Scott later sued Irene for his freedom in 1847. There were two appeals in the circuit court. Scott lost the first appeal, but won the second appeal. However, Irene challenged the order in front of the Missouri Supreme Court, and the Supreme Court overturned the decision of Scott being a free man. In 1850, John Sanford became a defendant in place of Irene when she got married and moved to a different state. And in 1854, Scott sued Sanford for wrongful imprisonment through the U.S. Federal Circuit Court of St. Louis. The court voted 7-2 in favor of Sanford, with Chief Justice Robert B. Taney writing the majority decision. The court declared that Scott was not free based on living in Illinois or Wisconsin because he was not considered a person under the Constitution. Taney stated that Scott was property of his owner and that property could not be taken from a person without due process of law, thus stating the Missouri Compromise was unconstitutional. The Dred Scott decision was finalized in 1857, and Peter Blow's son purchased Scott and his family and formally freed them.
The Dred Scott decision sparked enormous political reaction and destroyed any chance of agreement between the North and the South. The case played an important role in the emergence of Lincoln into the Republican Party president candidacy of 1860. It set stage for the secession and the Civil War. The 13th and the 14th Amendment were both catalysts of the Dred Scott v. Sanford case. The 13th Amendment ended slavery, and the 14th declared all people born or naturalized in the United States legal citizens.